This is Info Live TV headline news, June 18th. I'm Daniel Ben-Nun.
The families of kidnapped soldiers Eldad Regev and Ehud Goldwasser were summoned on Wednesday to meet with Ofer Dekel, the top negotiations coordinator for Prime Minister Ehud Olmert. Dekel recently returned from a trip to Berlin, where he met with German officials who are mediating the negotiations between Israel and Hezbollah. Although the outlines of the prisoner swap seem to indicate that Regev and Goldwasser are dead, their families have received no official word on the matter, and Ehud Goldwasser's father said not to expect any dramatic developments before the weekend. Prime Minister Ehud Olmert is expected to make a statement on the status of the negotiations in the coming hours. Prime Minister Ehud Olmert said on Wednesday that the release of abducted IDF soldier Gilad Shalit was an inseparable part of the ceasefire deal reached with Palestinian militant groups in the Gaza Strip. Israel officially confirmed today that the Egyptian proposed ceasefire would go into effect at 6 a.m. on Thursday. Speaking a few hours after the confirmation, Olmert stressed that he had not and would not negotiate directly with terrorist elements and reiterated that Shalit's release was inherent to the truce deal. Government spokesman Mark Regev stated that Israel is interested in direct bilateral talks with Lebanon in order to reach a peace deal between the two bordering countries. Regev said that every issue of contention would be on the table, including a key border dispute over the Sheba Farms, a small piece of land controlled by Israel but claimed by both Syria and Lebanon. The Lebanese government has made no official response to the new Israeli proposal. President Shimon Peres arrived in Petra on Wednesday morning, where he met with King Abdullah II as a part of a global conference entitled Petra IV, Reaching for New Economic, Scientific, and Educational Horizons. The leaders discussed a series of political and defense-related issues, including the peace negotiations between Israel and the Palestinian Authority, the indirect negotiations with Syria, the prisoner swap with Hezbollah, and the complicated situation in the Hamas-ruled Gaza Strip. Foreign Minister Tzipi Livni said Wednesday that Israel's leaders should be bound by the state's values and morals, referring to an ongoing corruption investigation currently underway against fellow Kadima party member and Prime Minister Ehud Olmert. "I find it unacceptable that whatever is not criminal is tolerable," Livni said at a conference held by the Movement for Quality Government in Jerusalem. Livni added that a system of social conventions must be established and that any elected politician who breaks them will pay the price. This past May, an overwhelming total of 300,000 tourists visited Israel, breaking Israel's all-time monthly record. Data published by the Central Bureau of Statistics shows a 60% increase in the number of tourists compared to last year, and a 5% increase compared to the current record from May 2000, the year Pope John Paul II visited Israel, which was considered the best year for tourism thus far. Thank you for watching InfoLive TV, Israel's only internet television network that broadcasts in four languages from Jerusalem to the world.